These grainy images of a supermarket security camera record a young child being abducted. A woman leaves, followed by the child, who appears distressed. The woman has taken the little girl's umbrella. Outside, the child will vanish, like tens of thousands of others before her. Chai Ching Kwan's daughter was abducted on June the 27th, 2007. These are the last pictures of her. Here in Shenzhen, a teeming industrial hub, criminal gangs target the children of migrant workers, like Mr. and Mrs. Chai, because they're transient, often fearful of the police, and whose grievances are rarely treated as high priorities. Mrs. Chai was distracted by exhaustion on the afternoon her child was taken, and so blames herself for what happened. The past 2 years have taken their toll on Mrs. Chai. She doesn't sleep much at night and struggles to stay awake in the day. Mr. Chai took us to the street near his home where his daughter was taken. The cameras in the shop were working, but not the ones out here in the street. China's strict one-child policy forced Mr. and Mrs. Chai to flout the law. They already had two sons, for which they were fined, but they broke the law again when their daughter was born.
Does he remember his sister?
Chai Feng is the younger brother. The cruel irony is that with his sister gone, the family is now legal again. Well, I've just learned that minutes after we left Mr. Chai's house yesterday, the police paid him a visit. And in fact, I've learned subsequently that the police have been round to see him every day for the past few weeks. He's not the only parent being watched, others are too. And the fact they're prepared to speak out to foreign journalists about their plight is a measure, I guess, of their desperation. Sun Hai Yang has transformed his home into a makeshift shrine dedicated to China's missing children. They include his son, who, like the Chai family's daughter, was also abducted 2 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
Mr. Sun knows for sure 3-year-old Sun Xiao was kidnapped because he too has chilling pictures of the moment his child vanished. The trafficker can just be seen leaving a toy to entice the child, and then are seen leaving together. All this happening just meters from where his father was busy with customers at the dumpling shop he runs. Mr. Sun and his family had only moved to Shenzhen from the north of the country 6 days earlier. He thought his son would have a better life here. Another hard-working parent who blames himself for the loss of his child. The sad roll call of Shenzhen's missing children, a list of almost 200 names, the result of Mr. Sun's own detective work. There are more names and faces on the website he helps run called Baby Come Home. Parents of missing children from across China exchange information and experiences. Some write blogs critical of the authorities, which are usually quickly shut down by the internet censors.
我弄电视啊、报纸啊，我拼命的上访呐、啊，唯一的目的就是希望中央能够重视，只有中央重视了，孩子才能回来。旁边吗？对。Mr.
Sun's 10-year-old daughter Sun Ye says she still dreams her little brother will come home, but after 2 years, it's getting harder to believe that will ever happen.
我跟他说，让他快点。以前他不能吃的那些东西，现在可以吃了，那些雪糕啊什么的。Traditional
beliefs favor boys over girls. Without a real social safety net, many parents rely on the boy to look after them in their old age. The country's 30-year-old one-child policy has only served to enhance their value. Boys sometimes sell for as much as $6,000, girls for as little as $500. Missing children simply don't make the headlines here, and it's the absence of that media coverage that has forced many parents to take matters into their own hands. They recently produced thousands of packs of cards like these. Each card bears an image of a missing child. We don't know just how many children have been abducted since the one-child policy began, because the central government refuses to release those figures. But China's state media recently reported that between 30 and 60,000 children vanish each year. According to Roseanne Reif of Amnesty International Asia, it's a figure that can't be openly discussed.
It's going to be very difficult to get any official statistics, because statistics at the provincial level or the national level on trafficking of women or children are classified as state secrets. So people are going to be reluctant to talk about it out of concern that they might themselves end up within the criminal justice system.
Despite the dangers, some, like Mr. Sun, are determined to speak out.
This is a very big problem. 没心情做生意，到处去找啊，上访啊，这必然是给这个和谐社会带来很不安定的因素。希望中央能够真正的重视，快点解决这个问题。
Mr. Sun's also had several run-ins with the police for refusing to remove the posters and banners that decorate his shop. 2 years on, his wife can barely imagine what's become of her precious son.
经常会想起，有一些我特别看到人家小孩喊妈妈，受不了。还看到人家小孩有的在街上讨钱呢，我都害怕身着在街上讨钱。
She worries because in some cases, a snatched child will be sold on to a gang of beggars or thieves like Oliver Twist.
The grief of the parents has been exacerbated by the response of the authorities. These are pictures of a protest broken up by police in Beijing last August. Mr. and Mrs. Chai were hauled away to shouts of, "How dare you question the government?"
有，当时就在那个那什么街啊，在三关了我们有三个小时，后来把我们送到公安部那个上访，我们不是去上访的嘛，他逼我们去上访。
Well, after those depressing and distressing interviews in Shenzhen, we've come further north to the province of Hebei to meet another group of parents who are taking matters into their own hands. They've been driving around the north of China trying to raise awareness about child abductions.
But there's a problem.
结果被那个公安盯上，到了太原以后，那个公安也到太原。
The police have intercepted their van, detaining them for several hours before ordering them to return to their home province, hundreds of kilometers away. The group those parents were planning to meet still want to see me, though. And so a clandestine rendezvous is arranged at a hotel in the provincial capital, Shijiazhuang. They're aware of the risk they're taking because the police have been watching their homes. So this is the only protest they can make inside the hotel room. Not all the parents of missing children are poor. Mrs. Wang owns a chemical factory, but she's also part of an ad hoc pressure group that includes farmers, laborers, and migrant workers. She holds the Six of Hearts playing card, bearing the picture of one of her two sons, abducted together in 1995.
啊，是啊，嗯，已经14年了。丢的时候是一个5岁，一个6岁，现在应该是成年人了，一个20岁，一个19岁的。
Does she think about them every day?
您是每天都会想念他们。
是的。
Does she believe in her heart that she will see them again?
您心里相信，就是说，您以后一定会见到他。
我相信的，我只要努力去找下去，那我就相信会跟两个儿子见面的。
These four parents say they're victims too, but the police regard them as troublemakers, saying their actions are creating social instability.
我感觉现在的警察不是在给我们努力的找孩子，他们是在努力的阻止我们。阻止我们找孩子，我们这个刚组织起来的寻子车队，他们就给我们砸了。
The ultimate penalty for trafficking in children is death, a sentence rarely imposed, although these parents would have no second thoughts.
必须逮住一个枪毙一个，逮住一个枪毙一个，必须得重罚，才能遏制这种逮小孩这个趋势，这个利用孩子挣钱做商品这个趋势。
要让他们受到绞刑，要让他们为自己的行动付出代价。
我不可理解，为啥他们把这个功夫用在我们这些家长身上，他们不把这些功夫用到人贩子身上？
我们这是在自救， 我们这是在自救，我们没有给国家给我们的党增加一点麻烦，说为什么他们不让我们去走，我都不能理解。我们没有靠他们，我们只是靠的我们自己，我们没有伸手向他们要一分钱，我们没有说是针对共产党，我们找公安部门不干，都好多不想活下去了。
Amnesty International says their despair is nothing unusual.
And unfortunately what they're meeting is local authorities who are trying to stop them immediately, harassing them, prohibiting them from going to the central government or to higher authorities, trying to keep them from talking to journalists, both domestic and international, about the issue. So they're really facing then human rights abuses themselves in an attempt to find their children.
So it's risky for them?
It's absolutely risky.
We made repeated requests to the Shenzhen branch of the Public Security Bureau for an interview. No one replied. But the Public Security Bureau's website is trumpeting one recent success, the rescue of 60 children following a six-month operation. State televisions also begun broadcasting reports about missing children being reunited with their parents. And just a week ago, Chinese police arrested over 40 alleged members of a child trafficking ring that sold 52 children over 2 years, reportedly earning nearly $60,000. What's never mentioned, though, are the many thousands still missing. Mr. Sun says he believes Beijing may be concerned about the issue, but that abductions are not a priority at the local level. This week, China's government faced more uncomfortable questions about the kidnapping trade when a question was asked on Dateline's behalf at a regular foreign ministry media briefing.
Can you give me a figure for the number of children classified as missing today in China? And does this confirm that the government is facing a huge social problem because of this? Thank you.
你知道中方坚决依法打击拐卖妇女儿童的行动。那么最近呢，据媒体报道，中方的公安部门也就此采取了行动，拯救了一批被拐卖的人员。那么这些行动呢，会继续依法进行下去。有关你提到的具体的数字，我建议你向负责部门或者主管部门去提出，向他们去了解。
Despairing of police efforts to find his child, Mr. Sun continues to defy the authorities. He's put up thousands of posters appealing for information about his son.
担心的，小孩子没找到，人贩子也没找到，就是损伤20万呢。有人只发信说。包括人贩子自己举报说孩子在哪里，都可以得到20万块钱。
A curious crowd gathers round him. They listen sympathetically.
看到这个人没有，就是这个人把这个孩子偷走了。
那个脸部好像看不太清楚。拿一张给我。
这个有这个小的更清楚一点的，照片。
还是这个包子店的。
是啊。
还没找到。
找不到吗？
哦，都是你儿子不啦？到了几年的了？
有两年了。
有没得的线索啊？
就是这家的是那个人家的，不晓得跑到哪里去了。
Most parents I spoke to exist on the hope they will see their children again, despite the attitude of the government and the police.
记得他哥哥在哪一个学校啊？他叫什么名字啊？他知道。我想他知道他长大肯定会回来的。
这个孩子，可以是觉得他是没什么问题的，他是活着的，只要活着我就能够找到他。